NRM is everything. Parliament has been reduced to an NRM caucus. The judiciary. There are some fears that some judges, some members of the judiciary have been reduced to movement cutters.
I think we need to go back and review this constitution. This constitution cannot deliver constitutionalism because it heaps all the authority on one person, and that makes that person a dictator.
These were some of the tough remarks made by lawyers who gathered at the Golf Course Hotel in Kampala to scrutinize how government has in the recent years conducted business in regard to abusing the rule of law. Speaking during their sixth symposium, the lawyers led by the keynote speaker, a former presidential contender in Kenya, Paul Muite, expressed concern on how government under its various institutions has continued to violate human rights.
A government cannot be considered a constitutionalist government if it arbitrarily locks up those it disagrees with. It is not a constitutionalist government if it beats up its opponent and shuts down newspapers or radio stations which it does not agree with.
The Uganda Human Rights Reports consistently cited the police as human rights violators, committing violations such as torture and many others. Despite many concentrated efforts to ensure human rights awareness among these officers,
corruption in the judiciary system was also at center stage, and it has continued to taint its image amongst the public.
But Ugandans are doing the best they can to catch up with Kenya. And Tanzania and Burundi are not too far behind. This then, my brothers and sisters, is a challenge that we as lawyers face. Unless and until our country transforms to genuinely inclusive political, economic and social systems, constitutionalism and the rule of law cannot take root, cannot become irreversible.
Corrupt governments hinder public participation in its processes, public access to information, and hinders accountability of state officials.
It's here that the lawyers were urged to remain focused and resist intimidation in the course of promoting human rights and access to justice.
Be honest with you. But honest leaders alone are not enough. It is essential that leaders become competent in the management of public affairs. Yet, they will not be competent if they continue with their own policy of muddling through and begging from what we used to call, now we use the consumer-friendly term of development partners.
Government has been tasked to engage its institutions, especially those that enforce the law, by teaching them about the rule of law so as to improve the current tainted image it has of human rights abuses. Shamim Batalwo, WBS News, Kampala.